Have information as far as the civil offense status is concerned, and Gina Mangieri is standing by. She also has a message from the governor. So, Gina, take it away.
That's right. I'm up here live at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center here at Diamond Head Crater. Now, behind me, in a room just up these stairs, we have dozens of state officials, including the governor, who have been meeting for more than an hour now and coordinating all of the state civil defense activity. Also, to a room to my left, we have several federal agencies represented as well, including the FEMA Initial Management Team and the U.S. Coast Guard. Just a few minutes ago, we spoke with the governor about how things have been going so far and what we can expect from here at state civil defense through the night.
Aloha, this is Gina Mangieri. I'm here live at State Civil Defense Headquarters at the Crater at Diamond Head with Governor Neil Abercrombie. Governor, can you tell us what's been happening so far the past couple of hours?
I think you folks have been doing a very good job of getting the basic message out. There was an earthquake off British Columbia. We are sufficiently forewarned, I think, to be aware of the possibility, which has now become real, of a tsunami wave or waves coming toward Hawaii. The main thing for everybody to do along all the shores of all the islands is to simply move inland. We are not opening the emergency shelters yet. We don't think that that's warranted at this stage. This is a question of getting away from the shoreline and moving inland in an orderly way. There's nothing to be worried about in that respect. We've got ample warning. And so I think if everybody just pays attention, does not do any unnecessary driving, if you're in your homes right now and you're away from the shoreline, stay there. Don't go out. And if you're anywhere near the shoreline, start moving inland and stay there until further notice. Civil Defense will be in touch with all of the stations, both radio and television, and we'll keep everybody up to the minute.
Governor, can we also tell people, sort of, we've been through this before, fairly recently, the other spring, what kind of resources are here, the people you'll be hearing from on a regular basis, and the kind of updates we'll be giving as time goes along?
We'll be having an update across all of the state. All of the counties will be up in about 15 minutes. We are at Civil Defense Headquarters here in Diamond Head and in communication with all of the counties. All the emergency services, whether it's a question of the National Guard, whether it's a question of the civil service collaborators, everybody's in touch with everybody else. The technology is all working, so we have the maximum amount of information that we get will pass along immediately to all of the media outlets. So the main thing right now is stay tuned. Stay alert and stay calm.
Thank you very much, Governor. And all state departments have been alerted. They're all following their protocol as well. And, of course, we have federal resources and federal agencies on top of this as well. And with us here at Civil Defense Headquarters, I have U.S. Coast Guard as well. And we'll talk to her in one moment after the, one more thing from the governor as well.
The main thing is for everybody to stay calm and collected and to be patient. The wave is not going to get here any sooner than it's going to get here, and we have excellent information on the timing, and so the main thing is patience at this point, and we will keep everybody informed. As we know anything, we'll get it out there. So the main thing is to, on all islands, on all shorelines, to move inland, be patient. As I say, stay tuned, stay calm, and everything's going to be okay.
Thank you very much, Governor, and he'll be keeping us posted through the evening. Among the many federal agencies we have resources for this evening as well is Captain Joanna Noonan, Captain of the Port for the U.S. Coast Guard, and she'll be telling us a bit here about what boaters and those along the coast should be doing. Captain?
Thank you very much. I have, as the Captain of the Port, I have closed all of the commercial harbors in the state, and I have ordered all commercial vessels that are 200 gross tons and above to evacuate. It is always prudent for vessels to leave the port. It's just better than getting bashed around at the pier. So I would encourage those other boats that are able to get underway and get out to sea to do that If boats are unable to do that, they should secure their boats as much as possible. And if there are any vessels that are 200 gross tons or above that cannot get underway, they should call the Coast Guard Command Center to let us know what their intentions are. But the best thing to do is to get out to sea, if not to secure your boat. If you do go to sea, please make sure that you have good communications. A VHF radio is always the best, food and water to sustain you for a number of hours. And please do not come back into port until the all clear is given from the port side. One of the things we found in the last tsunami is that it was the all clear for the roads was given, but at that point there was still quite a bit of surge activity happening in the harbors, which made them unsafe to come back into port until many hours later. So please do listen to the radio and stand by for the latest information. Bye-bye.
And thank you. That was Captain Joanna Noonan with the U.S. Coast Guard. We'll have more for you live from the State Civil Defense Headquarters at the Diamond Head Crater. Gina Mangieri.
This is Gina here back at State Civil Defense Headquarters. And of course, since that first interview with the governor moments ago, something has changed. They are opening emergency shelters now at this time. With me to tell us more.